Okay, so we're gonna go hike first before we take off down the road. Then we're gonna take off down the road. Yeah, let's go.
There's a strange dog in front of me. Good puppy. Good girl. How you doing, pretty girl? This really cool little trail here. Alright, so the last trail was just a quick, like, quarter mile hike. Now we are fixing to go on the mile and a half one way, or mile and a quarter one way.
Started this trail. I don't know why I'm going down it. That's a long while for me to go. But we're gonna try it and see how far we can go. There's a hole there to my left. Dude, that is up there.
That's cool.
That is so cool.
That's awesome. Gotta grab my camera out there.
They use them for fire starter, don't they? Anyhow, if you guys know the comment or know what tree these are, leave it in the comments below. I can't think of the name. Oh.
So beautiful through here.
What'd you find, Mimu? What'd you find?
It's a bird.
You gonna get it? You gonna get it? You gonna play with it? Oh, there's a little squirrel.
God it's so peaceful through here. Alright, I'm gonna set my camera up and I'm gonna get us walking down this.
Wow. She works a lot for the shots. But look at this view. I'm gonna be walking around with my head up. I love the forest. It is absolutely beautiful. Now let's see. Yeah, down the hill. Good thing we didn't drive the bus down here. There's a 8-ton, well, I guess it's 8-ton, not 20,000 pounds. So, no, we'd still be good to drive over this in the bus. The bus weighs around 23 to 20,000 pounds. 8 tons per axles, 20 tons. What's that? 60,000 pounds? No, it's not 60, it's 40,000 pounds, so... 20 tons is 40,000 pounds. We could drive across this bridge with a bus. And let's go look at this. Because this just looks creepy. I don't know if I'd really want to drive across it in the bus, but I could. Sorry. Kill myself or break myself. Oh, hey. You guys see that? It's a pretty stout structure underneath. It looks like it's been supported. Added supports to it to help it handle it. So there's steel underneath that bridge. This looks like it's a rink-a-dink bridge. Anyhow, let's go across it now. And there is the beach. And a picnic table. Alright guys, this is a view of the ocean to the right, your left, my right. I'm going to tell you guys, just to bring you guys in a little bit farther, has a smell of fish with a little bit of moisture, and you get the cold moisture temperature in your nose with a little bit of the warm from the field. So you know how you're sitting out and you can smell the nice cool breeze, but still get the warmness in both breath and each nostril. With a little bit of light breeze. It's very slight fishy smell. Not a heavy, overwhelming. It definitely is a wonderful smell. Look at that view. So, finally made it to the ocean. Well, not quite the ocean. I'm still inland quite a ways, but closest I've been so far on this trip. If you guys look around behind you, you'll see all the houses and the wonderful view of the mountains and the Olympic Mountains. And over here are some more wonderful mountain views. Oh man, those houses have it. And it's almost fall here, so you can see the changing color leaves. Sit back and enjoy the sounds of the ocean. feel free to sit around and listen to the oceans and relax. If you guys want more ocean sounds, stay to the end. And I'll put all the clips I removed of just the sound of the ocean wave crashing on the shore. Next stop, Ho. Is it Ho River? Yeah, it's Ho River. Camping out in BNR. And don't forget, if you guys want to listen to more ocean sound and ambisonic audio, this is a cool after this.